seeing by taking the some example. So employee table I am taking right now and offices table. So before choosing the relation, it is necessary the query which is returning something, and that is to be handled by the same type of the column. Okay, see, let me explain by the simple example first to show me. Select star from employees. Okay, employees. Okay, select star from employees. So I just need to get the form. Now I'm executing this part. Now, what are the various attributes we have over here? Just let me give it to you. Employee number, last name, first name, extension, email, office code, report to, and job title. Okay. And if we don't have enough space, so we can use another thing. That is, we can see the description of the. We can see the description of the this schema. So what is the syntax? Of course, this is the syntax. And after executing this part, we can now here it will show employee number. We have last name, first name, extension, email, office code, report to, and job title. Okay, this office code is an attribute, and that is also available, or that is also handled by the offices relation. So we have the BC offices. So just let me check. Yes, office code. So office code is also available as a primary key in offices relation, but as a foreign key we can use in the employee. So after seeing all these points, let me clear what is my query. My query I'm asking basically, I just need to display, okay, just to display employees who work in offices, who work in offices in the USA. See, let me clear to all once again. In the employees, what we have? We have the office code. We have the office code. We don't have office name by country. Okay, we don't have this one. Okay, in the case of the offices, the offices relation, we have name of the office by country. Now this problem is clear to all. I just need to display the name of the employee who work in offices in USA. Okay, let me know this query is clear to all. So what I'm asking here, we are using two tables to get or fetch the information. So nested query will be applicable where you are fetching something from the multiple tables. Okay, so nested query or subquery is required when the you are fetching the multiple when you are fetching the data from the multiple tables. Now this problem is clear to all, then I can write the query. But before writing the query, first let me know. Is it clear to all? The problem is, yes, clear, sir, to all? Okay. So select, I'm writing the query. Just select last name. Last name is an attribute of the employee. And first name again is an attribute of the employee. From which table you want to pick? I want to pick from the employee. Okay, so where office name I can't take. Why I can't take office name? Because office name is respective country is not available over here. So I need to use only office code. That office code that should be in select office code. Okay, office code. See, what you want to select and what is to be written by the inside query, that is to be opted or that is to be kept by or held by the office code. So that is to be required to hold office code. So we can say the office code or the attribute of the both set that should be same. So returning attribute and the holding attribute must be same. So select office code from vegetable, of course, offices. I'm just writing capital V for note purpose as well. So offices and where country equal to USA. So inside the query, what is written? This query will return the list of the those country. Okay, just let me execute this query first before adding anything. Just let me execute this query one by one, then you can. Okay, now see, if I'm executing this query, then what is it to be written? Let's see. It will return the office code only. Now 1, 2, 3. Okay, we are the country belong to the office code, so we are getting the office code 1, 2, 3. Okay, so this point is clear to all. First, let me know. This query is clear to all.
Yes.
The country which we know to USA. Okay, the office code will be written by this country name, that is 1, 2, 3. Okay, now it is okay. If I'm writing or if I'm executing the annual query, just like select star from the employee. Okay, employee. Just I need to display the office code as well. So let me see the result as well as the office code. Office code. If I execute this query, then what would be the result? Now you can see it will display the last name and first name of the employee as well as the office code or the all the list of the office code. That is 1, 6, 4, 2, 3, and so on. So there are so many details are coming. But how to determine which office code belong to the USA from the employee? From the employee table, if I need to find the office code which belong to the USA, so this is my query. It means I am just getting the multiple data, or so I am getting the information from the multiple table. So instead of taking or executing these two query, and I am unable to see all the details. One query, and I need to execute the query one by one. So it will not show the perfect relationship. So it is a better idea to, by using the nested query or sub query, we can do. So now you can do over here. Select last name, first name from employee. We are getting this information from the employee table where office code in. So this part is known as the this part is known as the outer query. This is known as the outer query. Okay, you have to keep in mind. And select office code. Okay, let me write here for explanation purpose. Select office code from offices where a country, and this is known as the inner query. This is the keyword. This is a few terms you have to remember. What is mean by the outer query and what is mean by the inner query? So inner query will execute first, and then outer query will get the information from the inner query to execute its part. Okay. So now let me execute this query and see what would be the result. So I'm just executing this query. Now see. Now I got the result of the limited employee who belong to the USA only. So, okay. If you want to display the first name or last name, so if you want to use office code, so of course you can use office code to see. Now you have remembered the answer from the office code. USA belong to only three different code. Those are the 1, 2, 3. So right now I'm showing the my example with the help of the office code as well. Now see the result. See 1, 2, 3. So this is the result. Why 1, 2, 3? Because I'm just writing here 1, 2, 3 belong to USA only. Okay, so this is the point. Now, see this query. Just tell me any doubt in this query, please tell me. Outdoor query, it is holding the display of the information to select last name, first name, and in office code, I'm also taking to explain the concept. That is the office code belong to the 1, 2, 3 only from the USA country. Yes, now tell me. Yes, tell me, any doubt in this query?
No, sir.
Okay, and for explaining the more example over here, so I'm just remembering an example. Just say just select star from select all from the payment. Okay, if I'm remembering the amount, for example, payments. So now you can see what is the value I'm getting. Customer number, check number, payment date, and amount. So okay, it's very simple. Now I'm taking the other query. Okay, so my query is over here. I just need to get the details of a customer. Okay, get the details of the customer. Customers who has the maximum payment. So what you will do, you are using a single table to get the detail. So of course it is also possible to get the data from the single table. So nested query is also applicable to the single table as well. So here we have an example. So now what is the syntax? Select star from from the table payment, of course, payments. Okay, just let me write properly to understanding purpose. Select star from the payment, and where amount equal to now inside the I'm just taking the select amount from payment. So what it will return? So inside query will return the payment, and that is to be assigned to the payment. So now after executing this query, you will see the result. Supplementary return the one row. So it is returning only the one row. So how it is possible to use at the time we are need to find the multiple things. See, so we need to find the maximum. So at the time use a max function. So after executing this result, this query, you will see now result. Now we got the customer number and check number, the payment date, the maximum amount from the payment tables we can see. So in a single table, it is also possible to apply the nested query. Okay, the beauty of the nested query is, or the subquery is to determine to get the data from the multiple table as well. But if you want to fetch the detail from your the same table, then you can access like this one example. From our classes, whose student got the highest mark? So the query will be like this one. Select star from the student. And where marks equal to select marks maximum marks. Okay, maximum marks from students data where subject equal to DBMS. So like this point you can see. So from the students relations, so we have the student name, roll number, and his or her marks or the respective subjects. So from the respective subject, we can easily find the this information by putting the query, that is kind of nested query. So first it will return the something information like select marks from the maximum marks from the student where the subject equal to maximum. So we can got the some information, and that information we are printing, so we are getting. But by the inner query, we can also get the same details. So there will be no issue. But it is also applicable to apply the nested query or subquery or a single table as well. But most of the time, we will always recommend it to apply the nested query or subquery to the multiple table from getting the data from the multiple tables. So now it is also possible like this. Okay. So what is the statement of this one? Get the maximum marks of DBMS subject from student table. Okay, so now this is my example. But right now we don't have any student table which is containing by the subjects, subject DBMS and marks. So I'm just right now closing this. Yeah. So this is the idea about the multiple query or the nested query and subquery. Yes.